morning, everybody. The Lord be with you. We welcome everybody here today in all the ways that you feel welcome. And we pray that the blessing of the animals would also be a sign of our love for creation and for their owners and for all the ways that we celebrate love today. Congregation, would you please be seated? So for those who are unfamiliar with the gathering, that is, it's related to the life and witness of Francis of Assisi, whose sainthood we appreciate and celebrate. And one of the ways that we do it in terms of creation care is by the blessing of the animals. We do not have that lovely horse that we had a few years ago, but maybe next year you'll be able to have more than one horse. The I was about to say all creatures of our Lord and King will be here for the first part, the what we call the confessional, and then after the collect we will have the blessing of the animals. By that time, this particular talkative one to my right would have breathed and inhaled the incense, did a kind of mantra, and was peaceful. If not, hambani gatle. But as I said in the cloister, everybody's welcome to stay, but you're also welcome not to stay. And it's wonderful. We also are mindful that the last time we were here, there were animals that we blessed, and today they're not with us. And the storm and sky and others who have gone into the ongoing place of paradise. So we are also mindful of the way animals come into our life. They bring comfort, and how we miss them when they are not in our midst. And we just have a silent moment for these individuals or creatures. Please stand. And we just have a moment of silence for especially the people in Israel, Palestine. And we make no distinction between when people die, people die. Their faith becomes insignificant, whether they are Muslim, Jew, or Christian. Somebody has died, somebody is without, as an orphan, parents are bereft of children. And we could just have a moment of silence when we remember those who have died and sadly are dying, and those who will pass on in the days to come. And in our private moment of prayer, can we just breathe and exhale as much of a quiet prayer for peace all over here on our soil, people that were invaded with gunfire in Sophia Town out in Joburg, the daily soundtrack of bullets here on the Cape Flats, now beloved city. So in all the ways that we seek peace.
Our service continue on page 104 of our prayer book. Praise the Lord.
Praise the servants of the Lord.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Let us confess our sins. We confess together. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, in penitence we confess that we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone, for the sake of your Son, Christ our Lord. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on you. Pardon your sins and set you free from them. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness and keep you in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We pray the collect, which is found on the inside cover of the pew leaflet. Almighty God, in Jesus Christ we find the meaning and pattern of our lives. Draw us ever close to him, that we may share in Christ's suffering and live in the power of Christ's resurrection, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God. Congregation may be seated. And we now have the blessing of the animals. And so, Father, we ask that you bless this creature of water, a reminder of the creation of our world out of the chaos when the earth was covered with water, and when Noah in the ark came with animals in pairs and began a new life under the symbol of the rainbow of promise. And so with the blessing of these animals, we pray for those who love them and in whose life they bring and cherish memories. Thus we pray and thank you in God's name. Amen. So you can come closer with your animals, and I'll do the tour around.
If everybody, no later.
Can we try as we call God's blessing upon these creatures that you love and care for, and we pray that they will keep you safe and you will also look after them with all the love that you are able to. And we thank God for St. Francis, in whose name we gather here today, and in the way that he showed us the best way to be a follower of Jesus is to be simple, is to be accessible to everybody. And dogs, in all the chaos, and cats, and there's a parrot there also. Are there any creatures that I've missed out? No snakes here? They may be crawling there somewhere in the pews. But in all these, we are mindful that God made us all. And I know for many times there was a debate whether there will be animals in heaven. And I wonder what kind of heaven that would be if there weren't any animals. If we can make it, they will certainly be there. I think they say, "Te prato talank." Is there a chorus that we can sing as those who want to leave? Kolongele Baba, kolongele, kolongele Baba, kolongele, kolongele Baba, kolongele, kolongele Baba, kolongele. Oh, I love you, my Lord. Oh, I love you, my Lord. Oh, I love you. Oh, I love you, my Lord. Oh, I love you. Oh, I love you, my Lord. Oh, I love you. Oh, I love you, my Lord. Oh, I love you. On se danki wo yer. On se danki wo yer. On se danki. You may leave as you feel. Danki weyer, on se danke. I don't hear you at the back. On se danke, on se danki weyer, on se danke. Can we give them applause of goodbye? I think I'm going to start getting a roving mic. As we sing, I'll just walk here and see. We now have the first reading. We then continue with the psalm and on the pew leaflet.
A reading from the Philippians. Ukuba kukho bani unokukholosa ngenyama. Bendingakholosa ngakumbi mna ndalukayo ngomhla wesibhozo. Ndingowenzala kaSirayeli. Ndingowesizwe sikaBenjamin. UmHebhere wamaHebhere. Ngokomthetho ndingumfarasi, ngokwenzondelelo ndilitshutshisa ibandla, ngokobulungisa obo basemthethweni ndingongena kusokeleka. Ndisuke ezi zinto zabe ziyinzuzo kum, ndazibalela ekuthini ziyinkxwaleko ngenxa kaKristu. Ewe, okunene ndisuka izinto zonke ndizibalele ekuthini ziyinxwaleko ngenxa yokongama kokumazi uKristu Yesu inkosi yam endithe ngenxa yakhe ndonakalelwa zizinto zonke ndizibalela ekuthini ziyinkunkuma ukuze ndimzuze uKristu ndifunyanwe ndikuye ndingenabo obam ubulungisa obo basemthethweni ndinoba obo bakhe ngokukholwa kuKristu ubulungisa ke obuphuma kuThixo ngalo ukholo ukuba ndimazi kwanamandla ovuko lwakhe nokuba ndibe nobudlelane naye ngeentlungu zakhe ndifaniswe noko kufa kwakhe ukuba ndingade ndifikelele ekuvukeni kwabafileyo kungekuko ukuthi sendamkele nokuthi sendigqibelele ke ndiphuthuma ukuba ndingakaganga nokuganga oko ndathi nam ndagangelwa khona nguYesu Kristu. Bazalwana, mna andizibaleli ekuthini ndigangile. Ke ntonye ndithi ndizilibala izinto ezisemva, ndisolulele kweziphambili, ndiphuthume umvuzo wobizo, ubizo lwaphezulu lukaThixo uKristu Yesu.
Hear the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Listen to the good news proclaimed in the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. And Jesus said, listen to another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a fence around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a watchtower. And then he leased it to tenants and went to another country. And when the harvest time had come, he sent his slaves to the tenants to collect his produce. But the tenants received and seized his slaves and beat one, killed another, and stoned another. Again, he went and sent other slaves, more than the first, and they treated them in the same way. Finally, he sent his son to them, saying, they will respect my son. But when the tenants saw the son, they said to themselves, this is the heir. Come, let us kill him and get his inheritance. And so they seized him, threw him out of the vineyard and killed him. Now when the owner of the vineyard comes, what will he do to those tenants? And they said to him, he will put those wretches to a miserable death and lease the vineyard to other tenants who will give him the produce at the harvest time. And Jesus said to them, have you never read in the scriptures, the stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone? This was the Lord's doing, and it is amazing in your eyes. Therefore I tell you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that produces the fruits of the kingdom. The one who falls on this stone will be broken to pieces, and it will crush anyone on whom it falls. When the chief priests and the Pharisees heard this parable, they realized that he was speaking about them. They wanted to arrest him, but they feared the crowds, because they regarded Jesus as a prophet. This is the gospel of Christ. I speak in the name of God's beloved. Amen. For many, many decades, the gospel text that I just read has been used in a most anti-Semitic way, because the reading, as Jesus tells the parable of the tenant and what they did to the owner of the vineyard, it is seen as an act of the Jews. And the emphasis was on their ethnic identity. And what the theologians of that time failed to do was to distinguish between the religious leadership of that particular faith community, how they made common cause with the occupying Romans, how they were
the lackeys of imperialism. And how they were even divided amongst themselves, but around Jesus they had a common cause to get rid of him. But this subtlety is removed in out of 20th century and even before that, where the Jews became the target for anybody that was having difficulty within the monarchy, within the economic situation, the way that foreign nationals are targeted in our country because they are Zimbabweans or because they are Congolese or whatever is their ethnic variation. We still have the stream within our society, Jesus Kalam Susa Jwat. That is an ancient, ancient line of persecution. The Jews were not only the merchant class of their day, a source of great wealth, but also a lot of the intellectual energy, scientific rationale came from the children of Abraham, and they were also the easy targets as the religious Pharisees and scribes and Sadducees focus on Jesus to detract from their own iniquity. But the focus of Jesus is not their ethnic identity, because he was a Jew himself and he died a Jew. It was not a Christian that was crucified on the gallows outside Jerusalem. It was a child who very proudly associated with that faith community into which he was inducted by that act of circumcision when his mother and his father took him into the temple, and Anna and Simeon could say, "Now I can go in peace, for mine eyes have seen the glory of the Lord." The glory of the Lord was incarnate in that Christ child. So let us be clear about that when we see who Jesus is focusing on. And the chief priests and the Pharisees, when they heard this parable, and I quote, they realized that he was speaking about them. They wanted to arrest him, but the person or the persons in the plurality that Jesus identified and who he embraced with his life cause that was terminated at the age of 33 was found in this, the crowd that was feared by the religious people, the crowd was feared because they regarded Jesus as a prophet. The ordinary people understood that. A lot of the women that followed Jesus understood that he was a prophet, and that eventually also that he was a Messiah. I emphasize the anti-Semitic nature of our society, even of our own faith tradition, even in the way we read the Gospel of John. The Jews did this, the Jews did that. And we don't make that distinction because we have been so subjugated by easy, cheap rhetoric, the Jura. That was not Jesus' message. He came for the house of Israel. And then later on, when he meets representation from the Gentile community, from the non-Jewish community, the Syrophoenician woman and others, that he is challenged to widen his scope and see all of God's people as being worthy of the promises of the kingdom of God. As you and I are sitting here, as we've slept through this windswept night, and in the days to come, people are dying. As they die so casually in a desultory way in our own Cape Flats,
Just on Friday night in Sophia Town, a congregation was invaded and gangsters, we presume, shot them apart, killing the pastor. But as all that was happening, Hamas, in a most organized way, crept out and orchestrated such mayhem upon the people of Israel. And when I abandoned my saturated viewing of the rugby match between Israel and Scotland and flipping between the two, I started watching the BBC, CNN, and the Arab Al Jazeera radio station. And the conversation varied from who you were listening to. The BBC, well, Hamas was doing to Jewish mothers, Jewish children, Jewish officers and soldiers, holding them ransom for future negotiation. The president or the leadership of the Ukraine aligned his voice, as did President Biden and others within the Western governance. Rightly spoke out strongly against the blood and the mayhem and the casual murder of people. But everybody within that mainstream of media was silent when it was just a few weeks ago, when something similar was happening in Gaza. And even as I sat there watching, I could see how the response, the retaliation was already happening, and multi-story flats were imploded, and all you see is a crumbling building and spumes of smoke and then fire. And it doesn't register to me, maar as mense wat daar dood gaan. I'm just seeing a building and I'm seeing vengeance. Today, you and I live in a country. At one time, I self-identified, and I still do, as a African. In the days of Steve Bantu Biko, of whom I was a disciple, and I'm still much informed by his teaching and that generation of black men and women that gave us a vision of a new South Africa with a kinder face of inclusion. And I was so proud to be a black boy from Elsie's River who didn't have to be ashamed when I walked around Voortrekker Road and the Boere light has come for me and I've got to run back via Ravensmead because I was a hot knot on the wrong side of town and Stoksilalien. And I grew ashamed of that and I internalized hot not. Steve Biko, Mampela Rampela, and others said, no, all who are not white are black. And it was not a phenotype of racial skin, it was a state of your oppression. And today, people look at me, and I spoke at the unveiling of the mural of the Black Christ in Salt River, and I said to people, ik leek slums en ik gooi kris. Because now I'm reminded, I can't be Khoisan. Because of the way I look. And now I've got to choose my slave descendancy. And many of us have not to say, but we are also such. But the chauvinism that's coming from certain sectors here in Cape Town has been nurtured when people are told, you are not this, you're not that.
And then we internalize that. Now you hear people saying the land belongs to us and not to you and not to you. As it is happening, whose land is in Palestine? It is about the land. You Zimbabwean, you don't belong here. It's about the land. Go back to your own land in Malawi. That is who we become. It's ugly. It is not of God. That anti-Semitic view that drove Jews into the camps of repression of the Holocaust. It was not of God, but it was named by Christians, by the same rhetoric that oppressed us and allowed us to be divided, black from white. And now the cheap, easy route is, whose land is this? Aborigines, Native Americans have always said, the land does not belong to us. We belong to the land. Go look for that in Genesis chapter 1, where the story is that we are made of the clay of the earth. And of the clay of the earth, we were shaped. Of the clay of the earth, we were shaped in God's image. That might have been aquiline feature, it might have had a flat nose, or it might have been Klarahara or a Kruskop. We don't know, because there was no social media to record that event, except that moment when this life was being made out of clay. I've said this before, I will say it till I can't say it again and again. And man and woman became a living being. And that is what we all inherit. Not a skin color. My nose I get from my Creole French grandfather that comes from Reunion Island. My Keterboro I probably get from my Oma, the Dutch blood. And the koi is very deep. The only truth that you and I can reclaim to, that God's breath is within us. And it's God's breath that makes us who we are, that makes us able to love animals and to feel the love of a dog and a cat. To feel it and to know it. It's that same breath that is divine that makes us divine. And when we accept that truth, the truth that there is within what Mayor Batlele read to us from Philippians, and it was read in Xhosa, I ask you to read it again in English, but when she reads this, not that I have already obtained this or I am perfect. He talks about being a follower of Jesus. And he's writing this not in a cloister in a desert. He's writing it from a prison cell in Rome. I press on to make it my own. I do not consider that I've made it my own, but one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead. Let those of us who are mature be thus minded, and if in anything you are otherwise minded, God will reveal that also to you. But this word, we strain forward. We strain forward. It is not to win the winner's prize, the first prize, the gold medal. It is to arrive at journey's end. There is a saying that comes from our continent. It might come from the Yoruba of Nigeria, but it says that if you want to, talking to the traveler, if you want to travel fast, go alone. Go alone. If you want to accumulate capital, if you want to do a big business, go it alone, invest and shop. You'll be that. Not only rich, you will be wealthy. Travel on your own. But the saying says, if you want to travel far, travel with others. They will slow you down. You will have to learn their mannerisms. You will also see their ability. And when we travel together, the farther the journey. We travel together to get us to 1994. We travel together to get Mandela out of jail. We brought him out of jail. We opened those doors. And once we've got him out, we were reminding ourselves that we are individuals. Corruption does that. Thievery does that. Power mongering does that, to emphasize the individual. But when we come together, which is the gift of this congregation, of this membership belonging, it's difficult. It's not perfect. It's awkward. But it's also beautiful. On Saturday, we celebrated the birthday of Desmond Tutu, who would have been 92 years old. And if he was here, he would be sitting there where Arthur is sitting, and he would give me the thumbs up, because what I'm saying here is what he taught us by life, word, and witness. So strain forward, people. Strain forward to build something for all of us. And when we build something for all of us, we build it for our children, for our grandchildren. We build the future now. We touch the future now when we strive together, because we do so not as Xhosa, Zulu, Muslim, Khoi, San, Khalid. We do it more than being African, which is a beautiful something. But when we do what Jesus calls us to do, and what Paul reminds us, to strain forward as the followers of Jesus Christ. Amen. Please stand as we affirm our faith.
We believe in one God, the Father,
Please be seated or kneel for prayer. As we come quietly before God, we thank you, God, for wonderfully and fearfully creating us in your image. Forgive us, dear Lord, when we look at others with prejudice, with disdain. And we ask that your Holy Spirit may stir us and lead us into all truths. Lord, in your mercy, in our prayer. We thank you, dear God, for Saint Francis and for all churches dedicated to the patron saint, to many congregations who are celebrating their patronal festival this week. We give you thanks for their life, their witness, and their ministry in the various communities where they serve. We thank you, dear Lord, that in the church, for all those who are associated and linked up with the Franciscan order, and for those who devote their life to a Franciscan way of life. We pray that all clergy and all those in this congregation may model our lives and think of ways of adopting ways of Saint Francis living in our lives. Lord, in your mercy, our prayer. O God, who has made all the earth and every creature that dwells therein, help us, we pray, to treat with compassion the living creatures entrusted to our care, that they may not suffer from our neglect, nor become the victims of any cruelty, and that in caring for them, we may find a deeper understanding of your love for all creation. Lord, in your mercy, we give you thanks, most gracious God, for the beauty of earth and sky and sea, for the richness of mountains, plains, and rivers, for the songs of birds and the loveliness of flowers. We praise you for these good gifts, and we pray that we may safeguard them for our prosperity. Grant that we may continue to grow in our grateful enjoyment of your abundant creation. Lord, in your mercy. O merciful Creator, your hand is open wide to satisfy the needs of every living creature. Make us always thankful for your loving providence, and grant that we, remembering the account that we must one day give, may be faithful stewards of your good gifts. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for all nations of the world, and we pray especially for our President Cyril Ramaphosa, our Premier Alan Windey, and our Mayor Jordan Hill Smith. Bless and guide them, dear Lord, and we pray especially for all those who find themselves in conflict all around the world. We pray for a soberness of thinking, a de-escalation of aggression, and we remember and pray for the safety and security of all those who are losing their lives in these futile battles. Keep your children, keep your women, and all those safe. Hide them in the wounds of Christ. Lord, in your mercy. God of manifold blessings, source of all that is good and true and holy, raise us up to see the world through your eyes, that we may treasure and each blessed creature alive with your spirit and touched by your creating hand. And may the blessing of this wonderful God, creator, redeemer, and sanctifier, be upon us. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, you have made all living things and even more wonderful than the things you have made. We thank you for giving us pets who are our friends and for those who give us so much joy in life. We cherish the pets we have now and we remember the pets we have loved and lost. And we bring before you, dear Lord, all of creation, all those whose names are included on our pew leaflet, those needing refreshment and healing and a reassurance of your presence. And we pray for all those who have passed away this week and for those whose years mind a curse today, Elaine Moore, Victor McClellan, and Robert Kirby. Lord, in your mercy, your prayer. And so, O God, we thank you for making the animals to brighten our lives. Help us to save them from danger as Noah did. Help us to love them and care for them as St. Francis did. And when we see the animals that you have made, help us to remember that you are holy and worthy of praise. Thus we ask in the name of the Father, who thought of the giraffe and the zebra, and of the Son, who was named after the beautiful white lamb, and the Holy Spirit, who came to us as a dove. Amen.
Thank you, Duncan. Friends, I just wanted to draw a few things to your attention. The marathon of Sanlam that's next weekend does impact on access to this part of the city. I'm going to try and contact other clergy of other denominations and see how we could find a collective way of engaging the city on this, because it's very restrictive. There's an assumption that everybody's on social media. It's an assumption that everybody comes to church every Sunday, and it's not always possible to do that. So for you to have a pass to get access, which is an unfortunate term in this day and age to be using, but nonetheless, that's the suggestion that has come. I'm going to try and contact the city tomorrow to find out, is there not a more accommodating way to facilitate access? So people say they're coming to a church. What else could they be coming to do? But they also probably have their reasons why they have this qualification. But for those who are here, there's a reception address. We'll construct a letter to say that so-and-so is the bearer of, is coming on business to, or coming to worship, and then you can print it and you can show it out. You know, we've got enough stuff to now, I must now be a pass officer. So please spread the word and say that, you know, that this is going to happen. But I hope that there's some reasonable way that we can, for us to have to come at Lekimoini, for us to come with a little letter to say that you're coming to worship Jesus. So that is the something that we need to resolve. And then Reverend Melanie is on holiday for a little while, and she should be back in the course of the month. And then also Auntie Sybil could see from the Lady Christian Home, tomorrow she's celebrating her 90th birthday. And if you are by the means to send a message, Ladies Christian Home here in the gardens, she will be delighted if there was such a message. And then our dear Auntie Connie Sylvester's also there. And please, if you could pass a message on to them. We also please hold in prayer Emma Rawandadi, one of our wardens. She's not well today, and please pray for God's healing hands upon her. Please stand. And so, beloved, may the peace of the risen Lord be with you always. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine, this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. For us it becomes the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. For us it becomes the cup of salvation.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and indeed our duty and joy, Lord and Heavenly Father, God Almighty and Eternal, always and everywhere to give thanks through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord. And now we give you thanks, because today you have gathered us together at this Eucharistic feast, so that we may be renewed in love, joy and peace. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we acclaim you and declare the greatness of your glory. We praise you now and forever, singing. Waza kubebelele kuwe, wasiqhekeza, wabanika abafundi bakhe esithi, thabathani nitle, lo ngumzimba wam unikelelwa nina, oku kwenzeleni ukundikhumbula. Kananjalo emva kwesitlo sangokuhlwa wathabatha indebe, waza kubebelele kuwe, wabanika esithi, selani kuya nonke, kubeli gazi lam nomqobisho omtsha, alipalelela nina nabaninzi, ukuze izono zixolelwe, ngamaxesha onke enisikhubanisela kuyo, oku kwenzeleni ukundikhumbula. So we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Terwijl ons dat zij doet in opstanding en al, offer ons voor u, Vader, hier die brood en hier die beker. En ons dank je dat u ons waardig gemaakt hebt om in uw tegenwoordigheid te staan en u te dienen. Ons vraag u om uw heilige geest op die offer van uw heilige kerk neer te sturen. Verenig allemaal wat in die heilige verborgenhede deelneem. Vervul hulle met die heilige geest en bevestig hulle geloof in die waarheid, zodat ons die saam mag loof in u, die die diener, Jesus Christus, mag verheerlik. Alle eer en heerlijkheid, sy aan u, Vader en Seun, met die heilige geest en die heilige kerk, nou en vir ewig. And so as Christ has taught us, we are bold to sing. Bread which we break is another sharing of the body of Christ. Beloved, draw near and receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood which he shed for you. Feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Behold who we are.
May we become what we receive.
Thank you. thanks unto the Lord, for God is gracious. Father Almighty, so, beloved, may God bless you with the grace to never, ever sell yourself short, with the courage to risk something big for something good, with the wisdom to know that the world is now too dangerous for anything but the truth and too small for anything but love. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you, and remain with you always. Friends, just before you leave, Jonathan Langenwerfen has asked that we, in the hymn, All Creatures of Our God and King, we leave out 5, 6, 7, the last three verses. Oh, 4, 5, 6, 7. You can not say it.
I think it's better if I say it. We leave out verses 4, 5, and 6. We must sing verse 7, Father.
Okay. It's my Woolies accent that he's jealous of. Beloved, the Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.